Well, people along the North Carolina coast are preparing, and they're expecting a lot of wind and rain from the storm.
And of course, people along the North Carolina coast have to decide if they are going to stay or if they're going to leave. And Rob Wu is in Cape Hatteras this morning with a look at how they're preparing. Good morning, Rob.
Yeah, good morning, Veronica. And I have to tell you, so far, conditions are not too bad here in Cape Hatteras. We do have the Pamlico Sound to our right, slight drizzle in the air, not very windy as of yet. But as you heard Brian say, that will change as the day unfolds. And we spoke to some people who say they're skipping all that. They're leaving first thing this morning. And then we spoke to others who say they're determined to ride it out.
For many in the Outer Banks, hurricane season looked to be over until Sandy seemingly came out of nowhere. And for some, right now is the time to go.
We're out of here. We don't mess around. Probably leave around 5 or 6 o'clock in the morning. It's going to be about a 7-hour drive, and I anticipate a lot of people are going to be leaving anyway.
At the moment, county officials do not believe they'll order any evacuations like they did last year for Hurricane Irene. Locals like Daniel Pullen say they're staying.
All the other times that I've left before, you leave and then you get stuck off the island. And then you're having to pay for motel, and then in the long run, it doesn't really add up to leave.
Even though Pullen and others may be skeptical of what they hear, they're staying ready. The area food line noticeably busier on Friday.
Forecasters normally tend to make it bigger than it is, but I'm a nurse, so I decided, well, you know, better safe than sorry. Load up on a few things and hang on.
Emergency officials are telling people to have 72 hours of food and water ready just in case. They believe Sandy will cause problems, but nowhere near the scale of Irene.
It'll be significantly less. Irene was a flood event, 7 or 8 feet of water. It impacted the sound front of the whole county. It was a significant damaging storm, and we're not close to that scale with this.
Now, officials around here are expecting anywhere from 35 to 50 mile per hour winds, 6 to 8 inches of rain. The entire storm can last anywhere from 20 to 40 hours. But as Brian can tell you, a lot of different variables that go down when it comes to projecting what will happen. So we'll just have to wait and see. Veronica, back to you.
All right. Thank you, Rob.